Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use the follow event to create this type of interactions on which an object is following another object or the mouse on the screen. So you can see if I rotate my camera, this object is still moving using the mouse position. So we will see how we can create this very simple interaction using the follow event. All right, let's begin. Okay, so I have a very simple scene in here that contains five different spheres. Each sphere has a size that is slightly smaller than the previous one, and they also have different colors. So the first step is to add the follow event to this main sphere. So I'm just going to create a new event in here, and then I'm going to select here the follow event. So if I go to the play mode right now, you will see how this works. And here the sphere is now following the mouse when I move. So let's explore a little bit these parameters in here, right? So the first parameter is called target. And by default, it says cursor. That means that it's going to follow the cursor of the screen. But you can also follow other objects, as you can see here. The second parameter says plane. And in here, you can control how do you want this object to follow the cursor. Is it going to stick to the camera? That means that it's going to be parallel to the camera, or it's going to use maybe a different plane. So let's say, for example, we set a floor in here, and maybe let's rotate this a little bit. So now when we move, what is actually happening is that it's moving across the floor. But because we are using an isometric view, it's hard to see. So maybe let's switch to perspective so it's easier to see what's going on. So if we make like a couple of squares in here, it will be a little easier to understand. You will see that the sphere is actually moving in the plane, right? Right. Maybe let's delete this and let's go back to the front by pressing Option R to reset the camera. Let's also go back to orthographic in here. Okay, so now that my sphere is moving with my cursor, and let's make sure that we have here stick to the camera. What I want is these other spheres to also move, but the trick is then to move following the previous one. So this one is going to follow this. This one is going to follow this. This is going to follow this, and this is going to follow this. So each sphere is going to follow the one that came before. So let's create a new event here, follow, and instead of cursor, this is going to be a sphere one. And now if we move, you will see that they are both moving, but because the movement is instant, it looks like it's only one sphere. So maybe let's add a little bit of damping. So instead of one, we can use 20. So now when we move, you will see that the previous sphere has a little bit of the delay. Okay, so let's do the same with the next sphere in here. So this is gonna be follow, and it's gonna be the sphere 2, and damping is gonna be 20. And then the same with this one here, follow, it's gonna be 20, and this is gonna be sphere 3. And finally, the sphere 4, the same, follow, 20 on damping, and then this is going to follow sphere 4. So now if we play this, we are ready. Now we finally have the effect that we were looking for. You can change the different damping values and you will get different results. Like for example, if the last one maybe could be 16 instead. So that means that that one is gonna be moving slower, right? So you can play with the values to achieve different results. All right, so finally, we just need to create a text in here, and this is going to be follow. And I'm just going to make this to be 230. And here, I'm just going to use this font that is called Readex Pro, and then just change it to bold and make sure that we have this in full white. Perhaps this is going to be center, something like this. And you can also switch to perspective in here, and then we move, it looks like it's moving across the text, right? So another idea is that you can create an animation for this sphere. So for example, if I create a new state for this to be like this, and then I create like an animation in here on the start to transition from the current state to this state. So maybe let's just make an infinite loop and maybe a little faster, like 0.5. And also let's enable here cycle to be ping-pong, and perhaps the movement will be maybe more drastic like this. So it's going to be very fast from one position to another. Right. So if we go to the play mode right now, the movement of the sphere is not driven by the mouse, it's driven by the transition animation of the main sphere. So you can modify this sphere maybe to be like a diagonal movement like this, for example. You can also combine the follow with the game controls. So instead of moving using the mouse or using the transition, you can move the sphere using the game control. And if I go to the play mode here, for example, you will see that now the sphere is moving and the other sphere are also following. But you can create this very interesting effect in which it looks more like a worm on a video game. So there's a lot of possibilities using the follow event. Alright, I hope you liked this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.